Welcome back to SnowRunner on Hard Mode. In the last episode, we completed the No Country for Old Truck mission and drove the Western Star Twin Steer from Island Lake back to the Smithfield Dam garage. There are two more vehicles on the Smithfield Dam map that we can recover, so let's switch back to the P16 and make a start on those. There are no fuel carriers back on the Smithfield Dam map, other than the scout carrier which we'll need to turn in for a mission. So I'm going to bring the fuel carrier we used to fill the twin steer back to Smithfield Dam. The raised suspension upgrade for the International Scout 800 is located in the swamp. It is a bit of a squeeze to pick it up with the P16 though. I'll leave the fuel trailer here for now, as we can head back into the swamp to find the International Transtar 4070A. Thank you. As capable as the P-16 is, it will not be able to drag both the fuel trailer and the Transtar back up the hill to the quarry, so we'll need to return for the fuel trailer later. At times like this, the P-16 has a tendency to stall out as it just doesn't have enough power to drag itself and another truck up the hill. But disconnecting the winch, moving forward, and then using the winch again to pull the Transtar up the hill will eventually get the job done. Transtar now back on the main road, I'll head back for the fuel trailer. From here on, the P-16 is capable of towing both the trailer and the Transtar. Drop off the Transtar at the garage entrance, and then leave the fuel trailer near the garage exit. We picked up one of the engine upgrades for the P16 back on the Drummond Island map, so let's install that now. I'm not going to sell the standard engine, as this upgraded engine can be used in other vehicles we may acquire later. I'm also going to add a high saddle so we can tow some of the heavy trailers with the P16. Let's bring the Transtar into the garage as well. I plan to sell the Transtar as it's pretty much useless on anything but paved roads, but there is an engine upgrade which is exclusively for this truck on this map, and we can make a few more dollars by selling the upgrade before we sell the truck. The final truck we can recover on the Smithfield Dam map is the White Western Star 4964, as part of the fixer-upper task, so let's head out in the P16 and do that now. The path down the hill is narrow and care is needed in the rocky section to avoid damage. Using low gear and the handbrake to slow our descent should allow us to get through safely. The White Western Star won't be added to our fleet until it's delivered back to the garage. One option to complete the mission is to take along a service or maintenance trailer and get the White Western Star repaired and running before trying to drag it back up the hill. While it can't be driven, it is easier to tow with the engine running. The other option is to use the P16 with the upgraded engine, which is definitely the brute force approach. Thank you. The same process we used to get the Transtar up the hill near the quarry can be used here. But the Western Star is heavier, traction is sometimes limited, and it is possible to get hooked up on the rocks or trees, so taking small steps and being patient will pay off here. Once the White Western Star is around the corner, the most difficult part of the mission is over. We just need to make it safely back to the garage. Just like the Transtar, the White Western Star is completely trashed just after recovery, but in this case I'm okay with paying $2,500 to have the physical damage repaired. There is still one more vehicle we can recover back on the Black River map, the Chevy Kodiaq C70, but I'll leave that for a later episode. Thanks for watching.